Hi, I've been using Docker Compose to build container images for my services in my application. I have an application which uses two services or microservices, TechTalks Producer and TechTalks Consumer. These are developed in .NET Core. And both of these, they are using multi-stage Docker build files to build the images and to run them. One of the things I have common between these two is the dependencies. So if you look at the dependencies for the consumer, we are using ASP.NET Core, the OpenAPI and Swashbuckle. And at the same time, if we go and look at the producer dependencies, we have some dependencies which are common across both these projects. So the things like the ASP.NET Core, Dapper Client, as well as ASP.NET Swashbuckle and OpenAPI, these are shared between these two. Let's go and see what is the problem that we are facing when we use Docker Compose. What is happening is it is pulling the dependencies for every build. When we do .NET restore as part of our build process, so let me switch back to the Dockerfile, which is used for building these images. This is the producer file, Dockerfile, which is building the producer image. So here we see that we are doing a .NET restore and then we do a publish using .NET publish. Similarly, we do it for consumer as well. Now, if I use the Docker Compose and I provide this file and I build the application, let's see how much time does it take to build this application. We see that the build is running parallelly, which is one of the feature of new build kit feature in Docker. So if we have two Docker files or two separate independent builds which can be run, it is running them parallelly. And we can see that from the steps here where it is saying loading metadata from the TechTalks consumer as well as producer, which means that both of them, they are running in parallel. Here also we can see that the same stage, the creation of work dir for producer and the work dir for consumer, they are running in parallel. And when it gets to the restore, we will see that the restore is running also in parallel. Let's also look at the total amount of time it takes to build. So far it is about 50 seconds, and by the time the complete build is completed for both of these images, we will see how much time it takes. Let this run for a while and let it complete the whole build process. Since we have only three or four dependencies, it shouldn't take that long. So now here we can see that both the producer and consumer are running the .NET restore command. And both are restoring the packages or their dependencies. And here we can see that they are targeting these dependencies in the .NuGet folder under packages, and these are under the root folder. They're trying to resolve the dependencies from there. And it's almost close to 140 seconds. So more than 2 minutes the build is running. And there we have it. So finally, by the time both these files were built, it was almost about 150 seconds. Now let's go and look at what is happening here. We saw that both the builds are running parallelly, both the builds are downloading the similar dependencies in parallel, and it's taking quite a lot of time. We can avoid this kind of lengthy delays in the build by using one of the feature of Docker build process called as the mount cache. So I'm going to comment these two and I'm going to try and reuse the build stage or the dependencies. I'm going to cache that. The way we do that is, let's say I'm in the producer Docker file. When I run the .NET restore command, I want to store the output of that .NET restore as a cache. And I can do that by using this mount type equal to cache. I give it an ID of some sort. So I'm giving the ID as NuGet here. And the target where I'm going to put this cache is in the .NuGet folder under the root directory and inside the packages subdirectory. Once we have done the restore, which means we have pulled the dependencies required for running our project, when we do .NET publish, we use those same dependencies, and we use that same cache. So by using this, we will pull those dependencies one time, but we will cache it for the subsequent runs. We will do the same thing for the consumer as well. Let's go and comment the first two lines regarding the .NET restore and the publish, and then use this cached version to do the same. So it is exactly the same here. .NET restore, we are putting it under NuGet packages, and we are referring to the same one in the publish stage. So let's go back and reuse this to build our container images. Now, if I run the command again, docker compose, and we give that file, the dockerhub.yaml file, and we give the build command, we will see that it's trying to run again both of these, the mount type cached command that we put in, at the same time. They are running in parallel, and it's trying to restore the projects or the dependencies. Let's see what is the output of this. And we get an error. The error is because both these builds are running in parallel, as we saw earlier, and both of them, they are trying to write to the same build cache. The ID is same, the location is also same. So we can try and overcome this by running the build for one of the projects first. So let's run Docker system prune to clear any of the dangling images first. Let's clear out all the unused images, and then I will run the same command again. But this time, instead of building the whole services, both the services, the TechTalks producer and consumer, let me first build the TechTalks producer, which will help us to build that cache. Instead of running both, which we saw gave us an error, I'm trying to run only the TechTalks producer specific build. So in the Docker compose, I can specify the name of the service which I want to build specifically, and that is what I've specified as TechTalks.producer, which is the name of my service in the Docker compose file. So if I look at the Docker compose here, we can see under services, I have the producer and consumer services. So I'm building just the producer service now, and it would take initially that slightly longer period of time because the cache has been invalidated. Whatever dependencies were downloaded, we have to download them again, and it is taking more than 50 seconds. Let this build complete, and then we will try to run the complete build again, and we will see how much time does it take. So here we can see that it is trying to run that cache command or mount type equal to cache, and whatever dependencies are restored here, it is going to store in this root.nuget packages folder. The first run, we might not be able to see much difference because here we can see that it is still running for more than 110 seconds. It would be the subsequent runs where we hope that this caching of dependencies gives us the benefit. So there we have the image created, and if we look at the final time, it is almost similar to the first attempt where we were trying to build both the images without caching. So it took about 147 seconds. Now let's go ahead and run the complete build, the Docker compose with both the producer and consumer services, and let's see what happens, because now we have the cache, the dependency cache has been cached in our build output. I'm going to run the complete build, and my expectation is that it is not going to rebuild the producer because of the way Docker works internally. It is going to build only the consumer, and we can see that immediately it is going to the consumer build only, and it's trying to run, or it's going to mount that cache here. So the restore part, it has used that cache. As we saw earlier, it used to take a long time here to restore that dependencies, and now it's running the .NET publish command, which is building the application. And here we can see that it's about 45 seconds at this point in time. And there we have the build created. It took about 66 seconds, which is more than half the time saved in terms of creating the image using the cache. So this is very, very helpful when we are dealing with a large project. In our example, this was a very small project with hardly 3 to 5 dependencies. But if we have large number of dependencies and every time we are trying to pull those dependencies without a cache, it could take quite a lot of time depending on the bandwidth of your internet connection. I think if we use this cache mechanism, and if we are using the same host to build the container images, it can speed up the build process by quite a few times. I've seen this working quite well even for other projects like Java. What we saw here is a .NET Core project. I would show this in similar circumstances on a Java project in a later scenario, but I hope you found this useful. And using this simple technique of just caching the dependencies as part of the Docker file, when we are pulling the dependencies and when we are using those dependencies, we are able to reduce the build time by more than half the time here. And in some cases, it could be even more than that. It will definitely give you benefits when you're trying to build large number of images. My application has just a couple of them. If you have more microservices and more container images to be built as part of your application, you can see a huge time saving by using this simple approach. I hope you find this useful. Do let me know in the comments if you have any better way of improving the build times faster. Thanks for watching this video. Until next time, code with passion and strive for excellence.